How do, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Freddy Adu at Arsenal. We've got a couple of home games today against Crystal Palace and Victoria Plzen. So a couple of home games, hoping for a good couple of wins. Let's see how we get on. Is it just me who has real trouble with inter-manager relations on these games? Because, like, I've tried with everything I've said to be nice about Mourinho. And then apparently I'm attempting to cool the war of words, which I wasn't aware there ever had been one. And where he's been really friendly with me up until now is now saying I'm backtracking and I'm utterly unprofessional. I don't get it. How do these things actually work? If I go on to Mourinho now, where's that thing about people he doesn't like? Yeah, he's up there with Conte now in terms of people that have the worst opinion of me. But we were friends. What happened, man? I don't get how it's supposed to work. Have I got to walk on it? Do I just say no comment every time I'm asked about another manager? Is that how you get good relationships with people? Don't get it. Whatever. Fucking Pardew. I need to say something bad about Pardew. I fucking hate Alan Pardew. He's useless. He's one of the shittest managers in football. How can I say something about him that'll make him stop liking me? Fuck off. I want to get bent, you fucking gay-haired twat. And speaking of the old Par dumpling, it's them that we've got next. Welcoming Palace to the Emirates. We've got Cech, Bellerin, Mustafi, Koscielny, Gibbs. It's basically back to the first team. Apart from Sanchez, who's still injured. But it will be. It will be. I have faith. It will be. You can be the man. Today and every day. Okay, so they're going for Mondonda in goal. Joel Ward, James Tompkins, Scott Dan, Papa Suare, MacArthur at CDM. Andros Townsend, Joe Ledley, Cabbage, Remy at left mid, okay, and Big Daddy Teke up top. I've got to watch for Big Daddy. We all know how good Big Daddy is. Cabbage is a quality player. Townsend is a good winger. I don't know about Remy on the wing. Not too sure about that. And I'm not too sure about this centre-back pair. I mean, they're both quite good, but I don't know if they'll deal with Giroud. If Giroud can return to form, I think he could have a good day today. Oh, here we go. Ozil with a free kick early on. Smashes it against the wall, but he'll pick it up. Put a cross in, mate. Come on. That's a poor cross. MacArthur cuts out easily. Can they counter with Big Daddy? Oh, dear. This isn't good for us. Come on, Koscielny. Oh, dear. Big Daddy is through and hits the post. Oh, got away with that one. Can we counter, though? No. Another free kick for Ozil. Better ball this time, please, mate. That's a much better ball. Mustafi. Oh, Mandanda saves it, but Giroud's there to tap it home. Is it offside or anything? No, it's not. It's a goal. Giroud back on the score sheet. Seventh of the season, and I think this is the sixth game in the league. Good ball in. Great ball in, actually. Mustafi with a decent header. Mandanda, it's an all right save, but he just palmed it down into the path of Giroud. Needed to be tipping that over for a corner. And Giroud doesn't need any second invitations. Good finish.
It begins!
Giroud back among the goals on a 7.1. Can our romance reignite? Can we rekindle the spark? Check with a free kick from deep. It will be well won. Gibbs. Ramsey. It will be again. Okay, lots of main front here, but we were always just trying to run through them all and he was never going to. Townsend. Pass out to Remy, the left midfielder. Remy. Joe Ledley. Well tackled Coquelin. That's what he's in the team to do. Break their attacks up. Here's a Iwobi. Don't just run at them all this time. Think of something first. Ramsey. Good play, Coquelin. Good play, Gibbs. Okay. Don't know what that is, but it's made it through to Chambo. Chambo shot. Giroud! We can indeed rekindle the love because he's back in the goals. Two goals in half an hour for Giroud after a few nondescript performances in the previous games. Oh, he's back. The big, sexy French beast is back. Oh, God, I love him, aren't you? You've got to love him. Right foot again. Whew! Getting a bit hot under the collar. Mandanda with a goal kick. Clearing it out towards Townsend, but Gibbs will win it. Can Ozil win that? Yes, he can. Here's Iwobi. Ball back for Koscielny. Ramsey. Excellent ball looking for Gibbs and an excellent run from Gibbs. What can Gibbs do? Can put it in for Giroud. What? I don't know what's happened. Okay, replay. Yeah, okay, I'm going to need to see that again. Yeah. I have no idea how that's gone in. I don't even know. I don't know what to say really about that. That was truly FM'd. If that goal had gone in against me, I would be fuming right now. But Giroud has a hat trick. Giroud has a first half hat trick. So let's just cut back real quick to what I said just before the game. I don't know if they'll deal with Giroud. If Giroud can return to form, I think he could have a good day today.
Damn, I'm good!
And now you know that I'm a genius. What the fuck was that? In the last couple of episodes, I've been thinking that maybe my love affair with Giroud is over, but half time, and he's already got three, and he's playing a 9.5. Yes, one of them was really weird, but he still put them all in. He's the best striker in this game. He's my favourite striker in the history of world football. I'm going to have to find the real Giroud and, like, I don't know, suck his dick or something. No, don't say that. Well, thus far in the second half, precisely jack shit has happened. But since we're 3-0 up, I don't really care. I'll make some subs or something, maybe. Oh, we've got a Champions League game, haven't we? Got a Champions League game in a few days. So I will sub off some of our more important players. Yes. One of them will absolutely be Giroud. Let's maybe sub off. Who else do we really, really need? I guess Koscielny is a pretty important player for us, because so Holding can come on. And Coquelin is a very important player for us for how we play, so Xhaka can come on. There's a lovely free kick. Headed sort of away. Erzl with a bit of space on the wing, just smashes into one of the defenders who didn't really know much about it. Here's Bellerin. Poor ball forward. Cabbage intercepts. Here's Zaha. They brought Zaha on, I think, for Remy. Here's Big Daddy. Over to Zaha. Someone go to him. Someone go to him. Never mind. Oh, here's Gibbs. Crossing. Headed away by Scott Dan. Bellerin nods it down for Xhaka. Xhaka for Ozil. Chamberlain. Oh, great back heel. Here's Bellerin. Can he finish off a great move? He can. It's 4-0. Hector Bellerin. That was a brilliant goal. Well worked by Xhaka and Ozil, and then a brilliant little back heel from Oxbow Lake. And there's Bellerin to tuck it home at the near post. Poor goalkeeping again from Mandanda. He is dog shit. Leave me at the crossroads, crossroads, crossroads. Meet me at the crossroads, crossroads, crossroads. Is this just the end, or is this actually a highlight? Chambo bangs one. Mandanda flaps it away. The fuck was that? Here's a Iwobi. Xhaka, bang one! Ah, never mind. Nay mind. Nay bother. Nay worries. We've won it. Just end, please. Thank you very much. 4-0 victory. We are absolutely bossing this shit, mate. Pure domination, as you can see, by the stats. And that takes us top, seeing as Spurs could only draw their game, and our goal difference is fucking unparalleled by anybody. Has anyone even got half of our goal difference? No, they haven't. The second best is Chelsea and Spurs with less than half of our goal difference. We are shitting on these cunts. And speaking of shit cunts, various people from Marseille keep talking about wanting to sign Coquelin. It's not happening. I'm not going to sell Coquelin. Both in real life on this game and in this save, he is vital to how Arsenal play. When he plays well and when he's on form, he's crucial to the team because he allows all the other more attacking midfield players to do their thing. Transfer status. Oh, that he's first team. I'm not going to say key player. And we will say that his asking price, I would let him go for 40 million, so we'll say that. Alright, Granit Xhaka's not too happy with his lack of first team football. I have played him a few times, I don't know what he's expecting. What's he been told in his contract? He's down as rotation, that's what he's been. He's been making appearances for me, hasn't he? Two appearances, three from the bench. In how many league games have we played thus far? Six. So he's appeared in all but one league game. How much does he want? Let's get Per to interfere. Come on, Per, do your thing. No, he wasn't. Okay, so I'm going to have to talk to him. But, yeah, he's had opportunities. Oh, he wants starts. Also, I was going to start him in the next game. I've offered mine not to now. Well, there we go. It looks like I've got out of it. Told him to keep his head, get his head down and play well, and I'll start picking him. He's desperate to show what he's got. What does he need to do to impress me? I'm not going to play him in the reserve because he's on the bench. I'll take a gamble and go with Terry. He's not happy with that. Okay, looks like I got away with it. I'm going to play him in the next game. I hate those conversations. It's similar to the manager thing. I'm no good at them. It's almost like I'm some social introvert who doesn't go out much and just plays video games all the time. Okay, so we're the Weather Eye on the next game away against Sunderland in the league at the weekend, which is one of those games that both in this save and in real life Arsenal is one of those games that we could easily trip up over. I have rotated a little bit, not too much. I do want to get a win here. I want to win all three home games in the group because that stands you in good stead. And this is probably the easiest game of the group at home against the weakest team. But I have still gone for quite a strong team. I've gone for my usual back four. I did nearly put Monreal in, but I don't want the defensive player in this one. I might well play Monreal at the weekend against Sunderland. So I've got my first choice back four. Coquelin alongside Xhaka, like I said. Ox, Fabregas in for Ozil. Iwobi, I was going to take Iwobi out for Lucas, but Sanchez could well be back by the weekend, so Iwobi can play now. And Giroud up top. I'm not gonna take Giroud after he scored a hat-trick, am I? Now, I'd run through their team, but honestly, I don't recognise a single name. Limburski? That just could just be a common name. And Resnick, isn't that the dude from Google Dolls? Isn't that your boy who did the Treasure Planet theme? That I love that song. Oh no, I skipped the intro. I can't do my 8-bit Champions League theme. I'll just play it now, bollocks to it. Fabregas for the corner. Coquelin heads it. Kozacic? Yeah, we'll go with that. Kozacic saves it. Run out of breath then. Don't try and hum the Champions League theme for too long without breathing. Whew. Okay, Bellerin plays it forward. Giroud will win that and flick it on for nobody. Case for Hubnik. Xhaka, Fabregas, tackled. Horava? Kopic? Is it going to be their attack? Bakos? Their play is very slow. Xhaka tackles well. Coquelin spreads it for Chambo. Come on, Chambo. Show me what you got. Take him on. Do him. Yes, good lad. Get the ball in the box. Getting the ball in the box. He has done. He's pulled it back, actually, for Coquelin. Oh, you little thunder cunt. Oh, that was beautiful. Play the fucking Champions League theme now. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. That's fantastic. Is it a full volley? Not quite. Half volley. Isn't he left-footed as well? That's incredible. That's an amazing strike. Commentating because I thought it was just showing the kickoff for some reason, but here we come. Fabregas. Oh, great save. Great save, Kozacic. Yeah, I'm going to go with Kozacic. There's an awful joke there somewhere. It's Johnny Resnick. If you know what that song is, man, your childhood was good. That film Treasure Planet. So did you know that, you know the main guy in Treasure Planet? You know it's Joe Gordon-Levitt. I had no idea that was his voice. When I saw it on Imager, I think, the other day. Are they gonna score? No. But yeah, I saw it on Imager. That's Joe Gordon-Levitt. I had no idea. Zahutstel is I'm just going to stop bothering. Good tackle, Coquelin. I said Coquelin, didn't I? I shouldn't really say that with my accent. I was trying to say Coquelin, you know, because he's French and his name's Coquelin and Coquelin is chicken and wine. but it just sounds like cocker van. You know, like a some kind of pedo in a white trans. I shouldn't be saying these things. Here's Gibbs. Down the left. In for Giroud. Now I'm going to have to leave the thing about pedophiles and vans in. Fuck. But Giroud's back. 4 goals in today's episode after a couple of episodes without scoring any, I don't think. And I'm regretting. I'll have to take the heartbreak off the thumbnail. Maybe put a heart, a complete heart there. Maybe sort of like a thing of me sucking his dick or something. And stop saying that. And there's half-time, 2-0 up. I think I might take a couple of key players off at half-time. Because why the fuck not? Because I fucking can, mate. Went all Manchester then, mate. What am I doing? Why am I talking like that? I sound like a bellend. Right. Santi can come on for Coughlan. And then you can swap roles. I'm better off doing this on the other screen, aren't I? And then you can swap roles with Xhaka. Xhaka doesn't like doing ball with a midfielder, but, tough shit. Go away. And the other sub I will make, I believe I will take Giroud off, and we will try Lucas up front, obviously not as target man. And we'll try him. He likes playing as false nine, that's his natural position, is it? I didn't know that. Yeah, fuck it, go on then, mate. And then maybe we could set Fabregas as, like, shadow striker. Oh, no, he's crap at it. Yeah, no, fuck it. Go on, roll. I didn't give a team talk, did I? Ah, well. Imagine if a real manager did that, just like walked in and said, you off, you on, and didn't give a team talk, just sent them back. I imagine a few have in the past, actually, when they're pissed off. Why is Gibbs on the right? Whatever, here's Santi. Lost a man in front of him. Like, I think Rabona passed, I think that was Gibbs. Xhaka, shoot, mate. Or just play in Iwobi. Xhaka, great ball. Fabregas, great goal. That's a great goal. That is a fantastic goal. We are so good. This feels like the rise before a fall. You know what I mean? How long since we conceded a goal? I'm fairly certain that they said something about Czech still having an amazing run of not having conceded. That's still going in this episode. Feel like we're being set up for a big fall. But let's enjoy the high for now. Yeah, everybody's looking complacent. I've got a sub left to take someone off before the weekend. Now, I've mentioned that I was going to play Monreal against Sunderland anyway. So players here that are crucial to the weekend game are Cech, who I'm not going to take off, Bellerin, Mustafi and Koscielny, and Ox. So let's take off the player out of those who has the current lowest percentage, which is joint between Koscielny and Ox. Koscielny has played a 7.3, Ox played a 7.4. Ox can come off. Did you like that logic? I've got no one to bring him off for. Oh no, Ozil can do that. Oh, Ramsey can do that. Yeah, Ramsey. Oh, here we go. Is this the game-ending highlight? Yes, it almost definitely is. Why bother showing me this? Nothing's going to happen, is it? Iwobi's going to play a pass, then Lucas will do nothing. Then we'll continue to do nothing. That's it. Why show me that? Just end. It's fine. You don't have to show me the last little bit. I wouldn't be, like, annoyed at you. Granit Xhaka vindicating our earlier conversations by getting player of the match. 8.3. Had a good game. I'll start you more, mate. I promise. I will. And we remain on top of the group. Scored 7. Conceded none. 6 points. PSG have won both their games too, but not quite as convincingly. And I'm guessing we'll play them back-to-back, home and away, next up. That will decide the group, I imagine. It looks like the both of us are set and looking good to go through, but those two games will decide who goes through top. I definitely want to win the group. Now, I talked about it earlier. People from Marseille keep sniffing around Coquelin. And now it's getting to the point where he needs an improved deal, because apparently people at Marseille are offering him more money than we currently are. He's currently on 67 grand a week. Now, I've already said in this episode, and I won't cut it out, I might have cut it out before now, but I'm not going to now, that he's crucial to the way we play, both in real life Arsenal and on this save. He's been excellent, so I am going to do it now. Oh no, 67k is what he wants. So if I just click finalize deal, is that just agreeing to that, or can I negotiate it? I'll negotiate it. What's his existing contract? currently on 30. See, when I read that, and I read it wrong, I admit I read that wrong, and I thought his current wage was 67, I thought that was fair enough. And if his current wage is actually 30, then yeah, I'd be asking for a new deal too, because he is vital to how this team plays. But seeing as that's what's happening, I'm going to say, we'll literally double your wage. How's that sound? Very good. It's a 5-year deal. I'm very happy with that, because if we just have a quick look at Coquelin, you're not going to see anything spectacular here, but he's started every single game, apart from the one against Man United. And he's played to a 7.05, 7.8. So average that out, it's probably about a 7.2. And he just 19 tackles in the league, in the 6 league games. That's what he does. He breaks play up. And you need that in a team. You need that in a team where you have luxury players, which is what Arsenal have. It's the current problem, in my opinion, with the present Barcelona team. If you're going to have luxury players, which in this Arsenal save I do, Fabregas puts a lot of effort in, but and so does Sanchez really, but Sanchez is a luxury player. Giroud doesn't do much outside of his target man stuff. Ozil is definitely a luxury player. Ozil doesn't do a whole lot at all off the ball. So in order to pay for those luxury players, you have to have players like Coquelin. If you look at that Barcelona team that just won everything, they had players like Messi who, when he's not on the ball, does basically jack shit. But to pay for him, they had hard-working midfielders in Iniesta, Xavi. They had players like Puyol with the work rate to carry those luxury players. If you don't have that, and you just have the luxury players up top and then kind of substandard or even more luxury players in the midfield, it does not work. Coquelin is crucial to this team. And I will happily pay him 60 grand a week. I'll happily double his wage. And that's a far more serious than normal end to an episode of this Arsenal save. I feel like I should make some kind of joke to end on. I think you know what song I'm going to cut in, because I was on about it for half of that match. If you've never seen Treasure Planet, go and watch Treasure Planet and enjoy this wonderful... What do you mean? Yes, I'm putting the fucking song in. I know that means I can't monetize it, but monetizing doesn't matter at this stage. We're getting like 5 views. I just want to get my stuff out there. It doesn't matter if I can't monetize it. Yes, I'm going to put the actual music video with clips from the film. Just go and watch Treasure Planet, okay? Just watch it. It's amazing. It's got this great song in it. It's one of my favorite childhood films. It's really underrated. Joe Gordon-Levitt.